Hello everyone and welcome back to the channel. I'm Mike, FreeSim, and in today's video I want to show you the 5 freeware tools that I always use when I start the sim. They're not that game changing, they won't change the sim overnight, but they make every flight go smoother, get more immersive, and it is just handy tools that make things easier for you, especially in VR. Let's start with the first one, and that is AeroTuneMFS, Microsoft Flight Simulator. That is an AI-powered performance companion for Microsoft Flight Simulator. It runs alongside the sim using live system load and flight phase dynamically tune settings like terrain LOD, object LOD with a high altitude, TLOD boost for cruise, and optional machine learning stutter detection mode, and that helps catch trouble early. So I'm using this everything. It's like auto FPS. If you go down here, you can have, well, let's have the pictures up here. So you can have a, if you're working, flying on a flat screen, so you can have a little display in the corner of your monitor, saying what your performance is, your CPU, GPU, and your RAM usage, and your VRAM usage. Now also there is, of course, the from the tray tool, you can open that, and then there is calibration, threshold, features, and you can set all these things up. Now, to tune AeroTune, go to the website AeroTuneMFS, and I did a whole video about it, going a little bit more in depth about this one. I still have to make a video to go, well, really with a deep dive into the settings and in the config system. But you can read here at aerotunemfs.com everything about how it works. And basically for me it is, I switch it on, I leave it there, and that's it. And I go flying. So yeah, this is a very, very nice app to have. All right, continuing with number 2. And that is SimTrim. SimTrim has been out for a while now. And SimTrim is synchronizing your analog elevator trim wheel, but it also works for buttons. So if you trim with buttons on your yoke, you can assign those buttons also in SimTrim. So what does it look like? Now let's open one of the screenshots here. So this is, for example, for the Bravo throttle quadrant. You can see all the buttons here and all the axes, and you can set the sensitivity for those axes as well. You can say, well, is it for trim or is it for taxi or none? Let's go to the next one, and that is for your alpha flight controls. So I have my trim switches, my elevator trim on my yoke. So I have assigned, I think it is button 22 and 23. And you can also assign a kind of sensitivity in here. It works with analog and digital things, and it works perfectly. Normally, when you trim out the aircraft and you switch on autopilot, and then the autopilot takes over the trim. Now, when you disconnect the autopilot, most of the time in some aircraft it will just jump back to your previous sim setting, and that will give you a jump or dive. I don't know, the airplane reacts like it's going directly to that earlier trim setting. Not with SimTrim. With SimTrim it will align itself to the current version of the sims because it's reading back and forward to it. So this works really, really good for trimming your aircraft. Really, it's a must have for everyone. All right, let's go to number, nope, wait a minute. We have a website also, makerspoint.com, SimTrim. What, how does it work? So there's everything in here on the website. So you can read it down here. I'll leave the links in the description below the video so you can, at your own time, read everything about it and download them all. or just one, or anyone you need. Maybe you have them already. Let me know what tool you use every time when you start up the sim. Right, number three, and that is hide this message. Hide this message. This message is a custom module for Microsoft Flight Simulator 24. It enables users to conceal specific notifications within the interface. All right. So we already know about the enter aircraft, exit aircraft that was in the Sim Update 4 build. Now, with hide this message, and that's a toolbar app, you can hide the enter aircraft. You can hide your controller has been disconnected, especially for those who use the VR controllers or an Xbox controller. And also resource usage exceeds GPU memory, that will pop up every so now and then. You can hide that message as well. Right now it is in a normal mode that it shows, but you can really easily hide it. So you see here at the bottom of the screen, it says Shift C to enter aircraft. And here you can hide it. You see it? Now it's blue. You hide it and it's gone. So just like that. Very easy to do. And you can do that for the others as well. It's also in different languages. As you can see here, it is in French. So yeah, this is a very handy tool. I think a lot of people already downloaded it. So, and this is from Gizmo Deal, and he made this tool really quick, and it is a very handy tool to have. And I use it every time, and I selected all three of them, and just do it one time, and it will remember that for the next sessions. Hide this message, very good tool. Now, the other one that I use all the time, and those two basically come together. So this is number four, and this comes together with the number five, but I call them both number four. So that is the Handlebar mod for Microsoft Flight Simulator. So what does this do? No more handlebars in your screenshots. All right, so you just download it, unzip it. Click on here, you see there is no handlebar on the top of the toolbar. And here you can see the before and after. So without this mod, you will get this handlebar. And you can hide it easily here with this mod. Works in 2D and it works in VR. Very handy tool. And of course, in VR, you want to make a switch or bind a key or a button on your yoke or your joystick for the VR toolbar toggle. And I will show that in a minute. Now this one comes together with the wrapping toolbar. Because, well, if you have many apps and tools, and some of them, they will come to your toolbar. And that one will look like this. So now if you combine both of them, you won't have a handlebar and all the other tools will be down here. So it's easier to find, especially in VR, to go through them. And I will show that to you. I'm gonna hide this one. All right, now let's go to the toolbar on the top. Here you see, these are my tools and this is wrapped. And if I move my mouse out of the area where the toolbar is, you won't see that handlebar showing up. I can move it around and it won't see my handlebar, and it just hides and it comes back. Very easy. And only when I go to where it is, then it will show. Easy, right? Now, and if I close some of them, so I don't need FS kneeboard, hide this message, I can get that one off, or maybe keep that one on. Communication, I don't need that one. The camera, basic controls, weather, EFB, FCR embed, I don't use that. And then, I don't know, there's already three. Okay, come up here. Bam. Now I see only this one. So maybe I want to hide the Airshow Assistant. All right, Airshow Assistant. Hide that one. Come back up here. There we go. And now I have a very simple toolbar up here. Now, if you want to use this in VR, you have to go to your control settings and then type in VR. This is a toolbar. I'm going to the this toolbar. Toolbar, is it the VR? Yeah, down here, VR toolbar toggle. And I've set that one. And I think that one is on my keyboard or. Oh, here it is. On the joystick button 3. So you need that one in VR to toggle the VBAR on or off. So I will hit this little white button here. That's toggle number 3. And then in VR, I can switch on the toolbar and switch it off. Very easy to do. All right, now, and the last one that I'm gonna use, and that's in here, and I already did a video about it, and that is, of course, the Toolbox, the Microsoft Flight Simulator 2024 Toolbox, and a very handy toolbox, and you can do many, many things with this one. See, I need to update it, but it's still working, so I'm fine with that one. Just read what it does, and I will show that to you here, what it looks like when I'm using the toolbar. Let's make this one a little bit bigger so you can see everything that I have in here. So you got your airport duplicate manager, your BGL manager, standard aircraft manager, replace intro, and you can also clean all your caches cache here in this with this tool. And I got all my other tools that I use right in here. So I can start the sim from the toolbox. I can start say intentions. I can start AeroTune, the network of charge, the hub to update my AirX beyond ATC. And then I got a web server that's for the all-in-one tablet, real turbulence. And I got a companion app that is for little nav map VR. So I've got all my tools right here in this toolbox. I can also quickly go to my community folder. I can go to my local cache folder. I can easily, well, open your user config file. Very easy to do that. And you can go to your content XML. So you got all these tools with just a mouse click away. Very handy to use, guys. All right, well, hopefully you found this more than welcome. So feel free to like and subscribe to the channel. This was Mike Vertisim, and see you in the next one. Bye for now.
Check the mic and make sure it sound right, boys.